This is Bill Slater with news shots from our sports album showing the wrestling match that cost Ed Strangler Lewis his championship. And out with Gus Sonnenberg. This is Gus, former Dartmouth tackle, practicing football tactics for his forthcoming match with Lewis. Sonnenberg better be in shape because his opponent was the originator of the grueling headlock, powerful punishing hold. Here's Lewis now. He's for 7 years. And here we go to February 24th. And the unbeaten Dartmouth grappler is in the ring. Here comes Lewis, knowing that his opponent is young, talented, and tough. Sonnenberg goes right to work by securing a combination bar and arm lock, a modified arm scissor, sending Lewis to the canvas. Gus, with his back to the camera, puts on the pressure in one of the most difficult to break of all wrestling holds. Up to this bout, Sonnenberg has never had an opponent last longer than 7 minutes. And his early work on the champion indicates he wants to get this one over in a hurry. Lewis thrashes in agony and kicks out to lessen the pressure. And there he did it. He broke the hold. The champion's on his feet. Sonnenberg is limping and Lewis is looking to grab him in a headlock. And he did it. Head chancery and body roll, and Sonnenberg kisses the canvas. But for once, the Lewis leverage isn't faking. Sonnenberg kicks loose, but when he does, he's groggy and probably wishes everybody would go somewhere and take him with them. They're back in action again. Sonnenberg knows what to look for, and in case he doesn't, there it is. It's a headlock, but Gus breaks it. Lewis locks his right forearm around Sonnenberg's head again, lifts him, and lets him drop to the floor. Then a head crash by Gus, and he wins the first fall. It's the best 2 out of 3 to decide the championship, and the challenger has the first leg. Let's see what Lewis is doing in the 15-minute rest period. He looks like a very tired champion, doesn't he? Hold everything, friends. Here they come again. And Lewis has his famous headlock working. They didn't call Ed Strangler for no reason, because this hold came very close to being an illegal one, which might possibly result in a fatal finish for Lewis's opponent. The referee is watching closely as the Strangler yanks Sonnenberg off his feet. But Gus kicks loose from the headlock and goes to the ropes for a respite. The end of the match is coming up as Sonnenberg butts, and the crowd sees Lewis land on the apron of the ring. He's back in, only to be hit by Gus's head again. Now it's Lewis who looks to the ropes for a rest. But once he sticks his head out, he's sticking his neck out because Sonnenberg lets him have it again. The winner in 2 straight falls, Gus Sonnenberg.